The intersection of two sets A and B is the set of all elements that are common to both A and B. We denote the intersection of sets A and B as A intersect B with this symbol. Notice the intersection symbol looks kind of like an A without a cross through the middle. When we're talking about intersections, we often use the word AND. It's easy to remember the intersection symbol if you think about AND and the symbol that looks kind of like an A. Here's a graph of the interval negative 1 to 3, where 3 is not included. Here's a graph of the interval from 0 to infinity, where 0 is included. What do these two graphs have in common? We're thinking about what's the intersection of these two intervals. Well, it looks like these two graphs overlap from 0 to 3, where 0 is included, but 3 is not included. So the intersection of the interval negative infinity to 3 with 0 to infinity, where 0 is included, is the half-open interval from 0 to 3, where 0 is included, but 3 is not included. The union of two sets A and B is the collection of elements belonging to A and or B. We denote the union of sets A and B as A union B with this symbol. Notice that the union symbol looks kind of like a U without a tail. Union starts with U, and the symbol for union looks like a U. We use the word OR when we're talking about unions. Here's a graph of the open interval from negative 1 to 3. Notice the endpoints negative 1 and 3 are not included. Here's a graph of the closed interval from 0 to 6. Note that the endpoints 0 and 6 are included. What's the union of these two intervals? Well, let's think about these two graphs. We want any points that are on either of these graphs. So if we take the collection of all of these elements, looks like we start at negative 1, not included, and end at 6, where 6 is included. So the union of the open interval negative 1 to 3 and the closed interval 0 to 6 is the half-open interval negative 1 to 6, where negative 1 is not included, 6 is included. The word OR corresponds to union and to the symbol, which looks kind of like a U. For a number to be a solution to a disjunction, a union, it must be in at least one of the solution sets of the individual sentences. The disjunction x is less than 3 or x is greater than 6, or in interval notation, the open interval from negative infinity to 3, or 6 to infinity, cannot be simplified. Let's look at the graphs of these two inequalities. Here's our interval negative infinity to 3, which corresponds to the inequality x is less than 3. Here's the graph of the interval 6 to infinity, which corresponds to the inequality x is greater than 6. Notice that these have nothing in common, so we cannot simplify our disjunction. When we put our two graphs together, we have two separate intervals. So our disjunction cannot be simplified. The solution set of x is less than 3 or x is greater than 6 is the set of all x such that x is less than 3 or x is greater than 6. Or in interval notation, we can write this as the open interval negative infinity to 3 union the open interval 6 to infinity. There is no simpler way to write the solution.